Morning, my YouTube fans. I'm doing a little Thanksgiving weekend special. Starting to lean toward more information videos. I hope this helps you. We're in full fall. There's a garden from up here. You see a lot of my garden videos. It's nice to see what's going on. Okay, let's see. What are we doing today? Hose nozzles. What could be so interesting about hose nozzles? Well, I'll show you. These are Home Depot hose nozzles. And there's something that kind of pisses me off. Here it is. Let's see if it's going to be clear, though. You see that spring? That's one spring in a whole load of pieces. And I don't know if you could see that it's rusted. I'll go closer, but it might become blurry. That's the spring that allows the hose nozzle to work. Without the spring, it doesn't shut off. So the problem is, our friends at Home Depot or their supplier knowingly provides us with a spring that's not compatible with water. Now, this is a hose nozzle. This is a water hose nozzle. You'd think that they would use a spring that might not rust. They take the time to make a beautiful brass adjustable nozzle on the tip there. And the adjuster used to be made out of brass in this earlier model 2 years ago. And you could see that even this clip here is not rusted. That's to allow it to lock in the open position. So, and the shaft that's in there is brass. All brass parts in the earlier model. But still, the steel spring, how could they miss it that it's not capable of withstanding water, that it's going to corrode? They could use a stainless steel spring, so maybe the hose nozzle will last. No, they got to use some kind of cheap carbon steel type spring that's going to corrode and fall apart. Okay, so this one fell apart, but I threw it in the box, and I went out and bought the new one. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I bought this one this spring. It's the new brighter orange model. I don't know if you could see that difference in the color. So this is a really bright orange one, which is the color insignia of Home Depot. Maybe they carry this one over at Lowe's too. I don't know. I haven't tested theirs yet, but here's the spring from this year's model. We got three chunks. It's falling apart. One summer of use. Again, a beautiful brass jet head. Yeah, it creates a jet action. Beautiful brass piece in there, the threaded piece. But what's worse about this one is you can't rebuild it because this is molded onto this. So you cannot take this out without breaking it. So it's not rebuildable. So the new one, which is more beautiful, is even more of a kick in the butt than the old one. This old one, by the way, I put a new spring in it. I don't give up easy. I got a nice heavy-duty spring. I put it in there. And you could see that returns. I put it on the hose already. First, I wound a spring, killed my fingertips. But then I got lucky and found a spring that fits. So I fixed the earlier model because it's rebuildable friendly. But it's this year's model that's really got me ticked off because not only is the spring still deliberately made out of a material that corrodes, I mean, if they don't know, I give up. You know darn well that they know that that spring corrodes in water. And unless you take the hose nozzle off the hose every time you use it, it's going to have water inside of it. So maybe what I'll do is I'll get a stainless steel spring, find somebody that makes a hose nozzle you can take apart, and put a stainless steel spring in it. But maybe Lowe's or maybe Walmart or somebody makes a hose nozzle that the spring is corrosion resistant. And you know, it's funny, I was very much into O-rings for many years, and the one thing that I learned in high school when I was in my teens was flare zone valves seem to be deliberately designed with O-rings that were not compatible with hot water. And we had the plumber there replacing our flare zone valves winter after winter after winter, which was a real kick in the butt. You know, my mother didn't have the, my parents didn't have the money, $75 every time he comes to replace a flare valve. We had three zones. I think we must have bought about 20 or 30 zone valves over a period of 20, 30 years, which is a real kick in the butt. But now I see, you know, beside, and that those O-ring materials, by the way, the one that was not compatible with hot water, it was Buna. And then I learned that EP O-rings were compatible with hot water. So I rebuilt my flare valves with EP O-rings, ethylene propylene, just in time to buy a whole new furnace. Too bad they didn't build them with EP O-rings from the factory. I gave them hell. I'm about to give Home Depot a call about this, though. Springs that are highly susceptible to corroding when wet with water on a water hose nozzle. Thank you very much, Home Depot. And all my viewers, beware. Have a great day.